नहीं पता नहीं जो थारी राय सो मारी राय नथिंग टू डू नो वे टू गो देखो सुनो मत बोलो व्हाटएवर यू आर 300% करना किसी को आओ मत कहो किसी को जाओ मत कहो ना कुछ पाना ना कुछ खोना जीरो कंप्लेंट लेवल मौज में रहो भी हैप्पी।
श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। The only purpose of our being human being is we are so fit that the divine chooses us to express through. Instead of ourselves remaining fit, we want others should be fit. And the samsara begins. Therefore, in this fourth mantra, it is said, Iha ched ashakat bodhum prak sharirasya visarasata tataha sargeshu lokeshu shariratvaya kalpate. If we are able to know our divine nature now and here, then only the life is fulfilled. Otherwise, again the same thing. Now this principle of rebirth, going to hell and heaven, is meant for what? All intellectuals suffer intelligently. Because they start thinking in terms of cause and effect. And therefore, this is used to tell them. If you do something wrong, you will go to hell. Nobody has seen the hell. If you do something, you will go to heaven. See? Or else, when we look at the world, some people are suffering, some are enjoying. So we again, the intellectuals ask question, why this person is so miserably born? Why? Because in the last life, he has done this is wrong. As a result of his own karma, he is having the miseries. So, intellectuals are controlled by intellectual explanation. But when we rise above being intellectual and start contemplating properly, then we come to know that eyes are meant for seeing, not for deciding or complaining, I like this color, I like that color. See? Mind is meant only for thinking, not for liking and disliking. Because liking and disliking has no logic. One person likes the red color, other likes the yellow color. What is the logic? But all our life is guided by only likes and dislikes. Therefore, spiritual practice is to rise above the likes and dislikes. And therefore, we have to recognize this, that in this very experience, life, we must rise above these likes and dislikes. Then what will happen? we will be abiding in our divine nature, like vision doesn't have liking, disliking for colors and forms. Mind doesn't have liking, disliking for any thought. In the same manner, the divinity that we are have no liking and disliking for waking, dream or deep sleep or samadhi. It comes and goes, we are the same. Therefore, we have to recognize the purpose of our life is we have to recognize our divinity now and here. After having told this, now the teacher continues, yatha darshe tatha atmani, yatha swapne tatha pitruloke, yatha apsu pari iva dadrushe, tatha gandharva loke, chaya tapayo iva brahma loke. Now this experience of the divine depends on the quality of the mind. See? Yatha adarshe tatha atmani. If we are able to distinctly, clearly recognize what? Experience without experiencer. When experiencer is born, samsara begins. Yatha adarshe, as in the mirror, we have no doubt when we look into the mirror, it is me. So although there is a perception of otherness, yet the knowledge is not corrupted because of the otherness. In short, he who is able to look into the world as he looks at himself, samsara disappears. See? Yatha swapne tatha pitruloke, then there is another abode, the pitrulok. And what is the pitrulok? When the mother, father dies or somebody dies, we do this thing, that thing, we do puja, we do the pindadan, then they will be fulfilling our desires because we have to do the pitru karma every fortnight, every month, whatever. Then they are looking from there, and if you do not do it, they will curse you. And then, yatha apsu ipariva drudrushe, gandharva loke tatha chaya tapayo iva. Gandharva loke is what? Those people who are engaged in the lalita kala, music, dance, etc. They are living only in the dream world. See, most of these people, they conclude their life in a most pathetic manner. So, and chaya tapayohi iva brahma loke. So, when we are able to recognize our essential nature correctly, then it is as distinct as light and darkness. And this can happen only while we are human beings in this very life. Now, after we are convinced that as a human being, the only purpose of our life is we must be such a fit instrument that the divine chooses us to express through. Such a simple thing. When I want to get some work done, what I do? I search for a right kind of person, capable, available, willing. But if I am busy, not available, then nobody will come to me. Therefore, those people who have got lot of time, they are good for nothing. It is said that if you want to get your work done in a new place, find out who is the busiest person. A person is busy because he is capable. Therefore, that Lord is also searching for who is capable. Now, continuing the thought further. Indriyanam prithak bhavam udayamastaya uchayat prithak udbatyamananam matva dhirona shochati. Now, how the spiritual practice begins? Dhiraha na shochati. What are the symptoms of a wise man? He is not miserable, and he who is not miserable will not make others miserable. A person who is miserable, he hates the happy people. Like many people scold us. What is their wish all the time? Be happy, get married and show. Because they are miserable. Who asked you to get married? See, friends. Therefore, matva dhiro na shochati. The first spiritual practice is be happy. But instead of being happy, we struggle to become happy. So, how it is possible? Indriyanam prithak bhavam udayamastau cha yat. Where from the sense organs come out and go back. See? So, the sense organs come out of the mind. The objects of the world come out of the sense organs. If eyes are closed, colors and forms don't exist for me. It exists for others. How does it matter? If I don't have money, that is a problem. But others have, let them have, it doesn't make any difference. Look upon yourself. Therefore, indriyanam prithak bhavam udayamastav chayat. Where from all the worldly objects come? They come out of their sense organs. Where from the sense organ come? They come out of the mind. Where from the mind comes out? It comes out of the eye, the faculty of discrimination. Where from the eye comes out? From the chetana, the life principle. Go back, reverse gear. When we are leading our spiritual life intelligently, we are the seekers of truth. But when we are leading our life intellectually, we are the most unfortunate people in this world. Simple people are not that miserable as much intellectuals are miserable. See? Most of the IT's fellows throughout the world, most of them, not all, most of them, they come from middle class, lower middle class families because of the intelligence. They have never seen that much money in their life. And suddenly the boom came and they lost their control. See, they are not Khandani Amir. Exactly the same way. When we get little bit freedom, prosperity, friend, therefore I told you, one is able to digest failures in life, but to digest prosperity perpetually is very difficult. See? Indriyanam prithak bhavam udayamastav chayat. Therefore, unless we go back, then prithak utpadyamananam matva, then we come to know that the one reality alone is mind. The mind alone is sense organs. Sense organs are alone the worldly object. Don't run in the world. No logic, no argument. Then what is the logic? We cannot smell by the eyes. See? What is the logic? We cannot eat by the ears. It is like that. But why? Sky is too high. Prithak utpadyamananam dhinaha na shochati. When you thus come to discover that we are the source of everything. And what are we? Bliss. But instead of bliss being manifested, blisters are manifested. What is the reason? Because we are leading our life at the periphery of our personality. Worldly objects disturb us, then our faculties disturb us, our mind disturbs us, and worst is our I. And all the disturbances, where do they go in deep sleep? They have no existence. There cannot be better spiritual practice than this. Just now one couple came, husband and wife. Wife complains about the husband, husband complains about the wife. They argue. So I said, cool, for 2 minutes. Mr. Husband, kindly separate yourself from the man. Mrs. Wife, kindly separate yourself from the woman and then start talking. Where are they? See, just imagine, for the sake of imagination, your own image is in 2 mirrors and they are live. They fight with each other. What will you do? Majara. Be friends. Therefore, come back to yourself. Then, indriyebhya param manaha, manasaha sattvam uttamam, sattvadadi mahanatma, mahato avyaktam uttamam, indriyebhya param manaha. So, the mind is, now this word para has got 3 meanings. Para means superior, para means subtle, and para means close. ये मेरा परम मित्र है क्लोज तो इंद्रियेभ्यः परम मनः माइंड इज क्लोजर टू अस सुपीरियर टू अस एंड सटल व्हाई सटल नो एट्रीब्यूट्स सेंस ऑर्गन्स हैव गॉट एट्रीब्यूट्स आईज कैन ओनली सी इयर्स कैन ओनली हियर माइंड एवरीथिंग आईज हैव गॉट शेप एंड फॉर्म Ears have got shape and form. Mind has none of them. Therefore, indriyebhyah param manaha, manasaha sattvam uttamam. Then subtler than the mind is the intellect. Now what is the mind? Mind is carrying the burden of likes and dislikes. And what is the intellect? Teaches us, rise above the likes and dislikes and follow the path of right and wrong. What we do, whatever I like, I will do it. Whatever I don't like, I will not do it. But whatever we like, is it right? Whatever we don't like, is it wrong? Think. So when our life is guided by likes and dislikes, we are samsari. When the life is guided by what is right and wrong, we are walking the spiritual path. See? So, manasaha sattvam uttamam, sattva dadi mahanatma. Then, subtler than the individual I is the total I. Try to understand this. See? Individual I is, for example, a Bengali. The way of talking of a Bengali will be influenced by where he is staying. If he is staying in Bengal, his Bengali will be different. If he is staying in Bihar, his Bengali will be different. If he is staying in Delhi, his Bengali will be different. Because the impact of the totality is consciously affecting the individuality. Therefore, totality is more important than individuality. Now come back to individual level. Whatever I do or I don't do, the impact of this, see on the totality. If I drink, if I loiter about, but then what about my family, my parents, my wife, my children, my husband, my father? What about them? No. Therefore, sattva dadi mahanatma. This is achieved in the devotion by surrendering our individuality at the feet of the Lord. And a person who is following this path will not be argumentative in life. See, friends. तू मैं सत्वा दधि महान एंड महतः अव्यक्तम उत्तमम देन वी कम टू नो सटलर देन द टोटैलिटी इज द डिवाइन विल देन वी विल डिस्कवर वन डे एवरी इवेंट इन अवर लाइफ इज प्लैंड बाय द डिवाइन फॉर अवर इवोल्यूशन एवरीथिंग गुड एंड बैड The best example I can think is when the hammer and chisel treatment is given to a rock. That time, what must be going through the rock's mind? Oh God, other rocks are so lucky, nobody is hitting them, and I am only being hit. Oh God, oh God. But when it is converted into a vigraha and worshipped by millions, that time, see. Every difficulty in your life is designed for our spiritual evolution. See? The best example I can think of is Tulsidas Ji Maharaj. He was born and his mother died and he was brought up in an ashram. Only males, no female. Throughout his life, he never came in contact with any woman. Mother, sister, auntie, uncle, nobody. Only the sannyasis. And he grew up very nice, everything perfect, all right. Then when he was doing katha, somebody saw that he's a good boy for my daughter, got married. That was the first time he came in contact with a woman in his life. That too as a wife. How much mad he must be after that? Your own experiences, I don't know. See? And one day it so happened, it was heavily raining like mad. He finished his satsang and when he was going, he went home and she was not there because she has gone to her father's place in Varanasi. Then he could not hold himself. Like a Hindi cinema hero, he went in the heavy rains like mad and when he reached there, she said, "Are you not ashamed? For this filthy body of bones and muscles carrying filth, you are so mad. If you are that much mad for Rama, he will reveal to you." She insulted me. I'll get married to someone. No. Out of that ordinary kathakar, a great saint was born. Tulasidas, we Devadas, jaao to jaao kaha, hard me jaao. See, friends, learn, learn, learn. So, indrebhya parammana manasa sattvam uttamam, sattva dadi mahanatma, mahataha avyaktam uttamam. Avyaktam is unmanifest. What is unmanifest in our life, we do not know. The only way is be prepared. See? And it has to be a positive approach in life. Then, avyaktatu parapurushaha vyapakaha alinga evacha yam jnatva mucchate jantuhu amrutatvam cha gacchati. Now, avyaktat, behind the divine will, tu paraha purushaha is the divinity itself. Purusha means what? Purishayanat purushaha and purnatvat purushaha. Purishayanat. Navadvare pure dehi daiva kurvanna karayan. Our body is called as puri. Jagannath puri. Bhel puri. Bombay is called as Bhel puri. So, in this body, whosoever is expressing is the purna purushaha. Therefore, Purishayanat, expressing through the body is Paramatma and for his expression, body is not necessary. Without the body also, he continues to exist. Light may be coming out of the bulb. If there is no light, nothing happens to electricity. Naito nahi, kya farak padta hai? So between these two, find out. Where are you? whether you take yourself to be somebody or you allow the divinity to express through you. Therefore, avyaktatu parapurushaha. The other day somebody asked me, Swamiji, you go to so many places, whatever you want, get every time. I said, yes, till date I have no failure of my desire. All my desires are fulfilled. How it is possible? I said, because my desires match with divine desire. Meaning, living at zero desire level, jo thari rahe so mari rahe, marwani bano. Dekho Maharaj, whenever our desires are not fulfilled, remember this, we are going contrary to the divine will. Life becomes so simple. So, avyaktatu parapurushaha vyapakaha, vyapakaha, we are limited to only this body. But the divine is expressing through every body. Our attention is only at the bulb. What about others? They are also life. Can we say a bulb or light in the temple is holy and toilet is unholy? My friends, we have to go back to our divine nature. That is the only purpose of Kathopanishad. Avyaktatu parapurushaha. And Purusha is one, Vyapakaha Alinga Evacha. All pervading, without Alinga, without any specific attributes. When I am a son, it is an attribute superimposed on the man. When I am a husband, attribute superimposed on the man. But then who is the reality? The man or the son? Or the husband. The real spiritual practice, you don't have to do anything, only change your focal length. That's it. How? Wherever, whenever, whatever you are, be 100%. Karnataka. Don't get entangled with anybody on any issue. Yam jnatva muchyate jantuhu, having recognized this divinity that we are, jantuhu, muchyate, they are liberated from what? Liberated from foolishness. We are all miserable, not because of anything outside, because of our wrong thinking. You come across, among the rich people, you come across happy and miserable. Among the poor people, you come across happy and miserable. So external poverty or prosperity has nothing to do with the joy or sorrow that you are carrying a burden in your suitcase. We are all miserable by our choice. And a miserable person can never distribute happiness. First, discover happiness. Then only you can distribute happiness. So, yam jnatva muchyate jantuhu, then amrutatvam cha gacchati. He attains, amrutatvam is not immortality, amrutatvam is fulfillment in life. What is fulfillment in life? Na jine ki tamanna hai, na marne ka irada hai. Let the life be lived through us. See, friends, only by hearing this, see the experience that you are going through. So simple. But suffer. Nobody can help you. न संदृशे तिष्ठति रूपमस्य न चक्षुषा पश्यति कश्चनेनम हृदा मनीषा मनसा विक्लुप्तः य एतद् विदुः अमृताते भवन्ति. नाउ अस्य रूपम न संदृशे संतिष्ठति. नाउ डोंट ट्राई टू सी गॉड डूइंग दिस एग्जाम ट्रायल, यू नो, looking here and looking there. How is God, 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 God? Drop all the sense organs. Then, na chakshusha pashyati kashchanenam. Nobody has ever seen God by his eyes. You can know the truth only by being the truth. It is your own experience. Can you know without being? Can you be without knowing? And in being and knowing, there is neither a knower is born, nor anything is created. See? In one word, objectless awareness. We are leading our life in the objective world, but objectivity has zero impact on our being. Therefore, na sandrushe tishtati rupamasya na chakshusha paschit kashchenenam hruda manisha manasa vikluptaha. We have to discover this truth only by perfect control over our mind. Friends, be attentive. Colors and forms are nothing but grossified mind, a grossified vision. Vision has no color, no form. But when it becomes grossified, it is called as colors and forms. Ocean has no shape, no size. But when ocean becomes grossified, they are called as waves. Water has no color, no form. When it becomes grossified, it is called ocean. In the same manner, sense organs, when they become grossified, five objects are created. Then mind is without any attribute. When mind becomes grossified, sense organs are created. When eye becomes grossified, likes and dislikes are created, mind is created. When chetana, the principle of life, becomes grossified, eye is created. In deep sleep, we are only life. Become grossified, identified with the body. I is created. This is the journey, my friends. This GPS is not in space. The GPS doesn't require any time. ETA. No. Now and here. And the best part is, it is not again. When a husband comes to know he is a man, is it again? See, na sandrushe tishtati rupamasya na chakshusha paschati kashchit hruda manisha manasa vikluptaha. In your own heart, in your own being. See? Ya etad viduhu, those who discover their divine nature, amrutate bhavanti. They attain fulfillment in life. Amruta bhavanti doesn't mean they become immortal. See? You know, Bhagwan Ram or Bhagwan Krishna, they are immortal. Meaning what? As long as humanity is on the planet, they will be there. But body-wise, they are nowhere. See? Yada panchavatishtante jnanani manasasah buddhishtana vicheshtate tamahu paramam gatim. Yada panchavatishtante jnanani. When all the five sense organs along with the mind, manasasa and buddhishtana vicheshtate, and intellect is not agitated, ताम आहु परमाम गतिम, दिस इज गॉड रियलाइजेशन। यदा पंचावतिष्ठन्ते, ऑल सेंस ऑर्गन्स आर सेटल्ड, मीनिंग सीइंग इज हैपनिंग बट सीयर इज नॉट बॉर्न, हियरिंग इज हैपनिंग हियरर इज नॉट बॉर्न, नो रिएक्शंस, देन ज्ञानानि मनसासह, माइंड इज एट पीस विथ इटसेल्फ। So what is the peace of mind? Peace of mind is that experience where the mind is not running after pieces. Take for example, words. Words are finite and many. So we keep on blah, 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 talking. So drop this finite. How to drop the finite? What is infinite? Infinite is silence. But that silence should be born out of wisdom, not of frustration. Abhi hone to phir dikhata hu. No. See, friends, such people, they are doing damage to themselves. Inside they are boiling. But they have no way to express it. So they either become perverted, or they have got horrible dreams, or one day they may take any extreme step in their life. Because they were suffocating themselves. Yada panchavatishtante jnanani manasasa, then buddhishchana vicheshtate. Then intellect is not. What is intellect? Intellect is the seat of logic and concepts. What we are talking is not a logical deduction. It is not a concept. It is experience, being, not becoming. See? Take this simple example. I want to go to sleep. So I is struggling to go to sleep, but in fact, in the sleep, there is no I. How simple it is. Buddhishchana vicheshtati tam ahu paramam gatim. Therefore, wise people are neither argumentative, nor logical, nor carried away by the whims and fancy of the mind, nor they are victims of their sense organs. Only by hearing this, see your own experience. This can be maintained 24/7. For that, the mantra is very simple. Dekho suno mat bolo. That is what we do. But then we keep on piling that inside. And one day it bursts open. See? Such people are strong ego. Very strong. And I tell you one thing. You may be knowing, not knowing, but I have handled so many cases like that. This happens when the married people enter a danger zone of their life. The danger zone is the second honeymoon time. When they cross their 40s, they start behaving the wrong way. If that time the husband is able to understand the wife, and the wife is able to understand the husband, such marriages stand. If they don't, the marriages break. Therefore, to go beyond the intellect, we must have an altar in our life before whom make it God, make it a temple, make it a commitment, make it a country, desh, anything. We must have an altar wherein we do not argue. Do what is told. Then only we can cross this terrible time of midlife crisis. See, friends. So, buddhishchana vicheshtati. Don't get carried away through logic and reason. Truth is beyond logic and reason. Tamahu paramam gatim. That is the ultimate attainment. ताम योगमिति मन्यन्ते स्थिराम इंद्रियधारणाम अप्रमत्तस्तदा भवति योगो हि प्रवाप्ययो ताम योगम इति मन्यन्ते दिस इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड अ योग व्हेन स्थिर इंद्रियधारणाम व्हेन ऑल आवर फैकल्टीज आर अंडर परफेक्ट कंट्रोल इंद्रियधारणाम टू थिंग्स ज्ञानेन्द्रियास कर्मेन्द्रियास दे मस्ट बी अंडर परफेक्ट कंट्रोल. And for that, our mantra, dekho suno mat bolo. Many times we talk when it is not necessary. See? One example, this is just example, it is not the truth. Because I cannot contain myself within me. So I find out a garbage can where I can throw the dirt. Hey, Buddhaji, don't tell anybody. I'm telling you because you are my special friend. Nobody knows about me, but I tell because he is my friend. See, when I was in the jail for the murder that I created, I ran away somehow. And then what to do? How to hide myself? Then I became a Babaji. But look here, I am telling you because you are my good friend, don't tell anybody. No, no, Swamiji, why will you tell anybody? He will also have a good friend. And after a few days, one of my good friends tells me, Swamiji, what people are talking about you? Purnamadaha, Purnat, Purnamadachate. We can't contain ourselves because it is like a vomit that is coming out. See, friends, therefore, few things which we have told you. Don't talk about your past to anybody. Don't ask about their past to anybody. But then I have to vent it out. Where can I go? Pakad pakad ke batao. So, tam yogam iti manyate sthiram indriya dharanam. All our faculties must be at peace. See? The other day somebody came to meet me. I was sitting. And after some time, Swamiji, what a peace here. I am feeling so relaxed. I said, don't sleep. What is happening? I said, because there is nothing here. Empty yourself. Relax. This is our experience, friends. When you are in the company of somebody, you feel agitated. When you are in the company of somebody, you are at peace. Like somebody is having the spray of some perfume, you can get that smell. Somebody is having a spray of Begon spray, you get that one. So, tam yogam iti manyante sthiram indriya dharanam. All our faculties are at peace. No agitation. Then, apramatta sada bhavati. Now be attentive. Apramatta means what? We are all expert in repeating the same mistakes again and again. Pramada is repeating one's mistake arrogantly. Pramada. Mada becomes Mada. See? Mada means one is overpowered by the emotions. Pramada, one gets established in that. See? So, apramatta sada bhavati. We are no more reacting to anything in life through wisdom. Apramatta sada bhavati yogo hi prabhavapyayo. But, see, this is not all. When we are in the temple, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Lecture on this. Prabhav apyayo. It will come and go, but keep on practicing, don't give up. And as a result, we come to deeper and deeper understanding of our being. Naiva vachana manasa praptum shakyo na chakshusha asti iti bruvataha anyatra katham tat upalabhyate. Now up to here, you have done it, so you are still on the periphery of your personality. Body, sense organs, organs of action, etc. Now the teacher says, Naiva vacha na manasa praptum shakyo na chakshusha. This truth cannot be comprehended by the speech, by the mind, or by the eyes. Meaning what? By the eyes, none of your sense organs will be functional. Then manasa, by doing the meditation, nothing will happen. And vacha, by only chanting, nom, 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 nothing is going to happen. These are only the external means up to a particular level. They are called upaya. Like we came up to the parking lot by the car. Then leave it there. But it is so expensive. No, it has got only entry up to there. Then we came with our shoes up to a point. Leave it there. If somebody takes, never mind, you take somebody else's. Leave it there. And when we come to the satsang, be attentive. Have we left our eye? Leave your eye. This is the truth. So, when we left the car up there, do we hate the car? Purpose is over. See? Similarly, the purpose of sense organs, we lead our life as a gentleman. Then the mind, we work by the mind without getting influenced by the mind. No more logic, no more likes and dislikes. Now vacha, we don't waste our time in unnecessary talking, arguing logically. Therefore, dekho suno mat bolo. Then, how the truth is attained? Asti iti bruvataha, only just being. Being without becoming. See how simple it is. The woman is, she becomes daughter to somebody, she becomes wife to somebody, she becomes mother to somebody. Who are the problem creators? The daughter, the wife, and the mother. Where are they? So the woman is in God's creation, no problem. But the daughter, the wife, and the mother is in our creation, Jiva Srishti. Therefore, asti iti bruvataha. Then what is to be done? Play your role. That's it. How to play the role? No, it is a natak, drama. There cannot be simpler spiritual practice than Karanataka. All our scriptures demonstrate this by one word. Make it a Rama Leela or Krishna Leela. Rama Leela means what? It appears everything is happening, but actually nothing is happening. Ours is a Satsanga Leela. As if you are listening. but I am talking. But this is also Leela. I am not talking to you. I am talking to my mind. If my words do not change me, do you think they will change others? See, friends, therefore, in satsanga, the one who is conducting the satsang is more benefited than the one who are sleeping in the, sorry, who are listening in the satsang. It was a slip of tongue. See, friends. So, asti iti bruvata anyatra katham tad upalabhyate. Therefore, first, we have to accept blindly. Recently, one person in Auckland, a Bengali from Bangladesh, I went to get earphones for somebody. And when I looked at him, I started talking Bengali. Oh, how do you know I am a Bengali? I can smell you are a Bengali. Then he became little open. He said, Maharaj, they don't say Maharaj, like Mohoram, Maharaj. So they said, you tell me, how can I be God? I said, okay, you are dumb. No, but everybody say you are divine, you are God. I said, then you are. But how can I? I don't trust, I don't believe. I said, don't believe. God doesn't need your belief. So he got confused. I said, why you people give so much importance to faith, faith? I said, look here, your very existence is because of faith. How? I said, now I will talk to a language what you understand. Tumko pata hai tumhara baap kon tha? One lady told you that you are my son. Do you know where from you are dropped in this world? Then that lady told you, this man is your father. Can you prove? Dad, show your DNA. Our very existence is based on faith. With the faith only we can begin. If that we don't have, we will be stuck. Therefore, asti iti bruvataha. So we have to have this clear thing. And how this faith is, be attentive. Faith interacted properly gets converted into experience. Now, you are. Being is knowing. Accept it without faith. Being is knowing. And practice it. Can I be without knowing? Can I know without being? Therefore, is knowing and being separate from each other? Or they are one and the same? But instead of remaining the being, we become. When being is corrupted, conditioned, it is reduced to becoming. And that becoming is also going, doesn't remain stable. We, as a divine, ever the same. Childhood comes and goes. First we become a child, then we become a teenager. Oh, how we become teenager? When childhood has gone, then teenager goes, we become middle age. Middle age goes, we become old age. Old age goes, others are liberated. We continue. Vai tamaku vai chuna. Friends, asti iti bruvataha anyatra tat katam upalabhyate. This truth cannot be recognized, experienced other than only being. Asti iti upalabdha उपलब्धस्य तत्वभावेन च उभयोः अस्ति इति उपलब्धस्य तत्वभाव प्रसीदति. Therefore, the truth has to be attentive, recognized as only being. Don't differentiate between jada chetana. So important, friends. आप ही माली, आप बगीचा, आप ही कलिया तोड़ता. The creator, the created, the destroyer. Everything is happening only in this. Therefore, asti iti upalabdha. This is the only way. Therefore, don't struggle. When I was sitting for meditation, you know, light came. It was so bright. I closed my eyes. But you were doing meditation with the closed eyes. Within the closed eye, again closed eyes. It was so much light. Then, but after that, for so many years I am struggling. Light is not coming. What is the reason? Tumhara bulb fuse ho gaya hai. Change your bulb. Remember one thumb rule. Anything which comes and goes is a flicker of mind. Hold on to that, which has never come nor gone. Never come means what? What is coming? It was not there early, then it came. When a child is born means what? Earlier the child was not there, then he was born. Do we have the experience of our absence? So how can we be born? But what happens? Association with the body, because a body born, I am born. Body grows, I grow. Body is fat, I am fat. And this will keep on changing. Again and again we have to assert, asti iti upalabdhavyah. Then alone the truth is recognized. Then tattva bhavena cha ubhayo. Then both ways, only being, being in being. These two things will happen simultaneously. I am and I know, this knowing and being, when it becomes homogeneous, it becomes merged. Then asti iti upalabdhasya tattva bhava prasidati. Then only one is tattva bhava, is abidance in the reality. Then only we abide in the truth. And for that, this is the most beautiful and my most favorite shloka from this Upanishad. Yada sarve pramuchyante kama yasya vridhishtitaha athamartyaha amruto bhavati atra brahma samashnute. Yada sarve kama pramuchyante hridishtitaha. When we come to live at zero desire level, sarve kama pramuchyante. Is it not our experience in the deep sleep? We have no desire. Now, one experiment. Suppose you have to catch a flight. Tomorrow I have to catch a flight in the morning. So when I will go to sleep, I will say, tomorrow I have to catch the flight for the morning. I should get up this way. And then, therefore, we fix the alarm. And after every 2 minutes, one desire to catch the flight in the morning will destroy your whole night's sleep. We are carrying the Himalayan desires. Whole life is destroyed. Do experiments on yourself. Therefore, yada sarve pramuchyante kama yasya vridhishtitaha. What is the meaning of giving up all the desires? One technique, give yourself zero choice. How to give zero choice? जो थारी राय सो मारी राय, ओ लॉर्ड दाई विल बी डन. एंड दिस कैन कम थ्रू विजडम. व्हाट इज द विजडम? एवरी सिंगल इवेंट हैपन्स इन अवर लाइफ फॉर अवर इवोल्यूशन. When you see in beautiful gardens, the gardeners come, they start pruning, cutting. That time what must be going on in the mind of the trees? See, they are cutting. See, in the jungle, there are nobody comes and bothers them. They can grow the way they like and all that. Here you see, but when the people come and start praising, oh, what a beautiful tree, what a nice pruning and all that, aha, then people will like to come and take a selfie with the tree. Or the jungle tree, anybody take a selfie? But the tree has gone through the chisel and hammer treatment. See, friends, I was traveling by train many years before, and I was on the the two-tier in the above berth. So the servants, they came and Babaji, what do you want? I said, hey, give me a cup of tea, black tea, no milk, no sugar. Okay, he came. When I wanted to pay him, he said, no, Mahal, this is my seva, please. I said, if it is free, give me another after 1 hour. He smiled, I smiled, he went away. There was one person sitting. He said, you people are very lucky, you get free. I said, you can join me, I got one dress extra. Try. Then I had to, out of courtesy, ask, what do you do, Bauji? Elderly person. He said, I am a freedom fighter. I said, you are still fighting? And did you get freedom? If you are a freedom fighter, will you have agitations to increase your salary? See, friends, when you are really free, you get everything free. See, friends, therefore, sarve kama prabhuchante, he takes care. Have complete surrender to him. Then, atha martyaha amruto bhavati, you have attained fulfillment in your life. While you are alive, you have attained fulfillment. It is not posthumous. Now and here. So, take this together. Now and here. Now, beyond time. Here, beyond space. We are carrying the burden of time and space. I am in Bombay, not in Pune. I am in September, not in October. We are limiting ourselves by these two attributes of time and space. And time and space are not real. Those of you who have come on their own choice, they will be enjoying this satsanga. Those of you who are tied down with a rope, chalo na. But we were told only 1 hour. It is 1 hour 3 minutes. You decide which category you belong. Atha martya amruto bhavati atra brahma samashnute. It is not a posthumous. If you do this thing, you will go to heaven. If you do this thing, you go to hell. Forget about it. Yada sarve prabidhyante hrudayasya granthayah atha martyah amruto bhavati etat eva anushasanam. Yada sarve prabidhyante hrudayasya granthayah, all the knots of the heart are open. What is the hruday granthi? Avidya kama karma. Avidya, incomplete knowledge. We all have incomplete knowledge about others. Forget about others. We all have incomplete knowledge about ourselves. And because of that incompleteness in the knowledge, there are agitations. Those agitations are called as desires. And when we are under the force and pressure of the desire, we start getting into activity. Hriday Granthi is this. And when nothing to do, nowhere to go, relax. So, we'll keep on going, we'll keep on doing, but not under the pressure. Thereafter, life will be lived. Now, when our vision is normal, do we require any struggle to look at somebody and find out? If our ears are normal, do we require struggle to hear? No. Life becomes effortless. Prayatna Shaithilya Ananda Samapati Bhyam. Patanjali says, whenever you are struggling, you are not normal. See? When a novice driving the car, he struggles, shouts, and those who are professional drivers, they make others miserable. See? There was one taxi fellow driving a foreigner, and one person came, stopped the car in front of his taxi, came out of the car and started abusing and shouting at the taxi fellow. And taxi fellow was calm and quiet. He didn't argue. And then he said, "You are shameless, bekar." He was keeping cool. He went. Then this passenger asked, "He spoke to you so much, you so cool?" He said, "No, he came out of the house. He wanted to unload the garbage that he was carrying. He found me free. He went away. It's okay. What comes out is what is inside. If you are at peace, you will never react in life. Then you will respond in life. This is what I said. Yada sarve prabhidyante hrudayasya granthaya. So what is hrudaya granthi? Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Living at zero expectation level. If I have this expectation from you, then listening to this satsanga, you will change. I will be committing suicide. Because you will not. Why? God failed. Do you think I will succeed? Then why are you telling? Because I am not talking to you. I am talking to myself. If my words do not influence and change me, do you think it will change others? Therefore, the real beneficiary in the satsanga is not those who are listening, but the one who is conducting the satsanga. But if the one who is conducting the satsang is also a walking type means what? Hindi, chalu type. What will be? Sri Bhagavad Gita says, Trividam narakasedam dvaram nashanam atmanaha kama krodhastatha lobaha tasmadeta trayam teje. Desire, anger is the gateway to hell, and somebody comes late. Why are you late? Anger, go to hell. See, friends, words must carry the meaning. When the words carry the meaning, then only they have impact on the listener. Why our wife, our children, our husband, our friends don't listen to us? Because our words are empty, carry no meaning. When we say, "Honey, darling, I know you." Because our words have no meaning, because it's mechanical. Yesterday also I told you I love you, yes. Tomorrow also you will tell. Therefore, yada sarve pravidyante hrudaya sakrataya athamartya amruto bhavati atra brahma samashnute. It is not a posthumous attainment. It is now and here. Atra brahma samashnute. Therefore, we are now concluding. Shatam chaika hrudayasya nadya tasa murdan avi nisrutaika tayor urdum annayam amrutam amrutatvameti vishvang anya utkramane bhavanti. Now this is the yoga technique. When you do your sadhana slowly, slowly, all your life comes and it goes through the head out of you. But this has nothing to do with us. What is said? Angushtavatra purushaha antaratma sada jananam hrudayasan nivishta tam swan sarira pravurya munjadishika iva dharyena tam vidya shukram amrutam tam vidya shukram amrutam iti. What is meant here is that this reality, the I, Angushtamatra Purushaha, you find out whether he is the real or the fake. Man is real, husband is fake. Woman is real, the wife is fake. In the same manner, Paramatma is real, Jivatma is fake. Don't get carried away. Last life, this life, next life, karma, papa, punna, enough is enough. Tam vidyar shukram amrutatvam. This divinity is our essential nature. Therefore, first of all, we have to get rid of our relational existence through understanding whatever, whenever you are, be 100% Karnataka. Then you will not be reacting to anything in life. When you stop reacting, then you are at peace with yourself. And when you are at peace, then you will think properly. You will not react wrongly. And then you come to know that whole world is mai eva sakalam jatam, mai sarvam pratishtitam, mai sarvam layam yati, tad brahmadvayam asmyam. Everything begins from me, existing in me, it goes back to me. This is the ultimate truth, my friends, and nobody can help us other than ourselves. Mrutyu proktam nachiketo talabda vidyametam yoga vidim chakrasnam brahma prapto virojo abhut vimrutyu anyo api evam yo vidati atma eva. This is Nachiket, and who got it from the god of death, Mrutyu, and this vidyam, yoga vidim, all the things that we are told in this Upanishad, anybody who will practice this, he will be also free from the wrong notions, and here and now he will be able to attain fulfillment in life. With this, we have completed our Kathopanishad by the grace of Yamaraj. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ओम शांति शांति शांति. हरि ओम. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः. हरि ओम.